Around the World with MS World. I'm Chief Medical Correspondent. I'm joined by Dr. Don Negroski, who is the Director of the MS Center of Sarasota in Florida. And we just heard the opening MS lecture, the opening lecture for ECTRIMS 2016. This is the largest MS meeting there's ever been, that the world's ever seen, more than 10,000 people. We talked about MS diagnosis and personalized medicine. What did you take away from this lecture?
I thought it was pretty provocative that the concept of therapy, step edit therapies, starting at one therapy, then going to another one, may be changing in terms of trying to get personalized therapies for a particular patient according to their phenotype or their presentation.
Yeah, I thought it was interesting. They were talking about the new EAN, so the European Academy of Neurology and ECTRIMS guidelines, where they're going to shy away from this first line versus second line versus third line, which is traditionally how the Europeans have classified medicines.
Yeah.
And instead, it's going to be the right medicine for the right person at the right time. The problem still is, how do you know what the right medicine for the right person at the right time
is? I think time will tell.
Right.
Yeah.
And so we saw a comprehensive list of different studies that are telling us about different potential biomarkers and other things like neurofilaments and other sorts of things that can help us do that. What was your sense of how things were done differently maybe in Europe than they're done in the United States?
Yeah, I think that perhaps they use CSF more frequently.
So they use the spinal fluid, yeah.
Yeah, oligoclonal bands as we do, but probably not as much.
Mm-hmm. And it was interesting how they were even challenging this idea of this dissemination in space and time on MRI, which is kind of classically how we define MS,
Yeah. Separation
in time and space, and saying, well, maybe if we flatten that a little bit, we'll find out a little bit more.
As well as the exclusion of secondary causes of white matter changes on the MRI, which by definition is fairly infrequent, I found. Maybe 4% of patients have a MS mimicker.
Right.
So in the States, I think we'll continue to kind of screen people for MS mimickers, but maybe not to the extent of screening for 100 and some possible diagnoses other than MS.
Yeah, that's an important part when a patient's going to see the doctor and make sure that it's really MS they're talking about. But also the alternative is true, where people say, oh, well, the doctor said I don't have MS. Well, then my next question is, well, what did they say you have?
Correct.
Right? Because you still have your complaint. You're still coming to see us for a reason. And I think that you should, whether you see an MS specialist or not MS specialist, I think you should leave having an idea of what it is that you actually do have.
That's right.
Well, I want to thank you, Dr. Negroski, so much for joining us. And I want to thank you at home for joining us as well.
Thank you.